Now, some people will sit here and say, this system isn't perfect, I don't like these questions, what about this, what about that? And I say, consider what we have, and consider your alternative. This system, with all its flaws, is a million times better than anything we have. The questions that we have, what you just learned, what you just experienced, they're conversation starters. Mm-hmm. They're there to let me find out, is she the modern day incarnation of Madison or Franklin? Because you sit there and you start talking to people, and all of a sudden you say, wow, Diane's really got it. And we all know what it is, right? You listen, and you say, boy, this Michelle over here, she's pretty good, right? Or Saul here, he could go up there tomorrow. And you know that, and this is just the first, right, group of people. Imagine when you sit down with 9 of your peers, and you go through a 4-hour process, and you choose 2 people to represent you. And so those 2 people go up the next weekend, and they're going to sit with 8 others who've also been chosen. And in that group of 10, they're going to choose 2. Absolutely. And so we've actually talked to people about that. We're searching for the modern day incarnations of Madison, Franklin, and Jefferson. Let that sink in. They're out there. We just got to go find them. Yeah.
So if this works,
this is a political paradigm shift. We've all been brought up all our lives to think there's 2 parties. Just as we used to think there was a typewriter, or there was this old telephone thing, or there was AM radio, right? Or we couldn't fly, or the world was flat. Things change. Technology allows things to change. The internet and social networking is allowing all of us to get together and to get 500,000 people rallied around an idea. As soon as we can get the different groups to coalesce around one idea, then this will happen.
Unless they clamp down on that.
Exactly.
Let them try.
Exactly right.
Let them try, right? Here we go. I started this system September of 2007 with just me. And I got 12 of my buddies that used to work with me. And I said, guys, come over. We had them over at the house. I said, I want you to work nights and weekends and help me build this system. And they're like, you're going to do what? And I told them a second time. And they said, okay, Tim, we've been around you enough. We know that when you set your sights on doing something, that it's going to get done. Okay. As crazy as it sounds, when you peel this back, and you'll do it when you get home, you can't find where this system will fail. Not that it's a perfect system, but if it gets the people together, it won't fail. They can try to stop us, but the more they try to stop us, the bigger this will get, right? As soon as we hit to that tipping point, as soon as we hit that tipping point of people, this will go. So when I started this, I had those 12 guys. We had 1 person a day. Then we had 10 people a day. Then we get 100 people a day. Most days today, we get 5,000 people a day. When I was on Fox, they drove 120,000 people there. And the only question is, well, why don't they put this on primetime?
They're afraid of you. They are afraid of you.
But you know what? It's going to take one national TV show that's not. So after today, I go to Cleveland tomorrow. CBN, the Christian Broadcast Network, they've already filmed a 30-minute special on Go. They haven't shown it yet. They want more. They're going to get me from the moment I get off the plane till the moment I leave Cincinnati, I think. They're following us around with the camera. Great. What they told me, you never know, they said, this is the most powerful system we've seen. We're going to get behind this. They broadcast in more homes around the world than any other TV show. If they do this well and put it on primetime, we won't have 500,000 people. We'll have 5 million and then 50 million. We'll get to all of them. We've got plenty of time.
I just want to ask if anyone's talking about it. It doesn't matter if it's Democrat or Republican. I think based on the numbers here today and across the country, people are fed up with the way things are.
Absolutely.
And in order for them to change, it has to hit a certain number. Well, the 100th monkey, I believe, is that the monkeys would eat the fruit and they were dirty, but they saw the scientists cleaning the fruit. When it hit the 100th monkey, knew how to do it. Monkeys on another island that had never met these monkeys learned how to do it. So what he's talking about is raising the consciousness of educated people to the point where it hits, it just dominoes into an avalanche.
Yep. So that's the tipping point that we search for, right? So that's why I'm traveling the country, anywhere I can go, day by day, city by city. I call it planting a seed. I've never been here. We planted a seed. Now we have 50 folks here. If you guys don't know Michelle Cook, back here in the back way, Michelle. She is your New York state leader. You started when we maybe had 50 people in New York, and I bet we have 2,000 or 3,000 now. Every one of you could go add to that by becoming a member. It takes an email address, nothing else. You're not committed to anything beyond that. And then you go back to your groups and say, guys, I know we got to do all these other things. We should absolutely pursue the precinct chairs and all these other things we should do. But in parallel, get on Go. Go blog about it. Go email your list. Convince your friends to become members. That 100th monkey is right around the corner. It's about to join us. Yes.
Yes.